You're listening to the IO Soapbox with Aiken. I'm an IO psychologist, which of course means no one knows what I do. Now on the show, we are going to talk about IO psychology. I'm hoping that some of you not in IO will want to join us, and those of you in IO will be inspired to break new ground. Now, let's get me a cup of coffee, because I'm tired, and then it's time for me to rant about random things on my soapbox.
So one way to think about IO psychology and the different graduate school options that you might take is to think about it kind of like pieces on a chessboard. By the way, I don't even play chess anymore, so I barely know what I'm talking about, so this should be a lot of fun. When you're choosing between a PhD and master's, there are a lot of different things to consider. Your PhDs are going to be more research-oriented, typically, again, variation. Your master's degrees are going to be more applied-oriented. Your PhDs are going to take longer, 5-6 years plus. Master's degrees are going to be shorter, 2-3 years. But your PhD is going to get you all this access to the board, and your master's degree is going to get you good access to the board. Your second type of graduate program you might enroll in is a PhD program, and that's much larger coffee. It's going to be longer, it's going to be more painful, it's going to be darker, it's going to be bleaker, but it's also going to give you something a little bit different. There are jobs and there are organizations, even in the applied world, that love the PhD and prefer it a little bit more than the master's degree. This is typically going to happen in research-oriented organizations where having that depth of research experience that is assumed to be given at the PhD level is prized. So pay attention to the organizations that you're looking at as well, or the kinds of jobs that you're looking into, and see if they typically look for PhD credentials, master's credentials, or both. In the next couple of episodes, we're going to go into more detail on what master's degrees are like, and how to prepare yourself for them, and what PhDs are like, and how to prepare yourself for them. Your PhD in IO psychology is a specialist degree. It is a degree that's going to take typically at least 5 years, if not more, generally requires independent research, and takes a lot out of you. But the PhD is the highest degree that you can have in IO psychology. In a lot of ways, you can think of the PhD as the queen on the chessboard. You can move in almost any direction, very flexible piece. Your PhD gives you the opportunity to move in all kinds of areas of practice, as well as different areas in academia. So your PhD is going to be a very versatile degree. You'll get a great deal of specialist experience, but you will also be very flexible in terms of where you work and how you work. So you get to be the queen on the chessboard if you have the PhD. The PhD does take a lot of time. It takes at least 5 years, if not more. It does require a lot of self-structure. It is a very intense program of study. Typically, PhDs are a lot like working full-time, but with research. PhD has the academic researcher kind of component. PhD might open some additional doors for you that the master's degree might be harder to open by yourself. You know, if you are committed to IO psychology in a way that you are willing to give up at least a half a decade of your life to become an expert in it, yo, that's what PhD programs are all about, right? You're giving up 5 years plus to become an expert in this topic. If you're not sure that you want to spend that much time in school, your master's degrees are shorter degrees. But of course, the distinction goes beyond that. As we've discussed, your PhD degrees are going to give you access all over that board. Your PhDs are going to let you get into practice, they're going to let you get into academia, and they're going to give you good depth into those areas.